Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This will now be a follow-up on my previous discussion a while ago. This is part three, lesson three of integral calculus. We are now through with the seven formulas on how to take the integral of functions in integral calculus, indefinite integrals. So, to illustrate those equations or formulas, I will now give you examples for integration problems. Okay, let's proceed. I will now give you examples of definite integral examples, okay? It's the application of the seven formulas I discussed from the previous two lessons. Okay, let's see if you could, apply those formulas and you could still remember differential and integral calculus. Okay, number one, the integral of 5x dx, what will be the value? We are given the integral problem, the integral of 5x dx. What will be the answer? Meaning, what will be the function after the integration? Or what will be the equation? Okay, let's proceed with the solution. The integral of 5x dx is equal to 5 is a constant, okay? X is a variable. So it seems it falls under the integral of b dv, in which the answer is b. That's c, right? It's just as simple as that one. Okay? So, but this is a constant and this is a function. And same as in differential, we are differentiating a constant times a function, we bring out that constant. And integral, it's the same. You bring out that pi from the integral sign. So it will now become equal to pi, the integral of x dx. But we must have to verify this dx here. We must have to verify this db here. Okay? There's always a verification because we cannot use this formula if this db here is not the same as the db of the given problem. Okay? So in here, this x here is simply equal to b. B is just a representation from the formula. So in here, u is x. Take the differential of both sides. The differential of u is du. The differential of x is dx. So this dx here is same as this. If they are the same, we could use this formula, right? So as simple as that one. So what will come out now will be pi, and this falls under the power formula. Okay? It should be x raised to 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 plus c. Okay? So this will now be equal to 5 halves x squared plus c. That's the answer. As simple as that one. If you want to verify the correctness of your answer, take the derivative, and what will come out will be this. Right? Take the derivative of this, or the differential, what will come out will be this. You can see it, because this will become 5 halves times 2x dx, it will now become 5x dx. This is now plus 0. It's same as the original equation. That's the answer. Okay, number two. That's a simple problem, but you must have to verify the value of dB if it's the same. If it's not the same, you must have to do something, right? Okay, number two. The integral of 8x to the power minus 5x squared plus 2 quantity dx. It's a sum. Don't be afraid, this is sum. Like in the differential, if there are several sums, take the differential individually. In integral, it's the same. So actually, you could expand, but before the expansion, to minimize our writing on the word, our word is not too much, okay? I expedite a little bit the solution. The first function is constant any function. Second one is constant any function. The third one is just a pure constant. And here, the u here is x, okay? Try to verify the dx. Try to verify the differential thing if it's the same as dx. du1 is equal to dx because u is just simply x, exact, right? And here, we got another u because this is another term, okay? u2 now is equal to x. Take the differential of both sides. du2 is equal to dx. It's still the same, exact. Why exact? This dx here is same as this if you multiply this to the second term. So after verification, the first two terms, the differential is exactly the same as the x. Okay, actually, we could just now use the power formula. Okay, so this will now be equal to, we bring out the 8, okay? The integral of x to the fourth dx, minus 5, the integral of x squared dx. That's the second term after the expansion. Plus 2, the integral of dx. We verify these ones that they are exact, okay? We don't have to insert anything for it to be under this, okay? So just use the power formula under integration. So 8 will be x raised to 4 plus 1, which is 5 over 5, minus 5 open quantity, x raised to 2 plus 1, which is 3 all over 3, plus 2. The integral of dx is just simply x plus c. It's indefinite integral. Then if we try to simplify, 8 over 5, the coefficient of the first term, x to the fifth now, the coefficient of the second one will be 5 thirds, x cubed, okay, plus 2x plus c. That's the answer. If you want to verify the correctness of your answer, okay, try to differentiate this one, okay, using your knowledge of differential calculus, and what will come out should be this equation here. That's why I told you differential and integral calculus is the reverse of the other one. Okay, you could verify the correctness of your answer by simply differentiating. And what will come out will be this. Okay, let's proceed with number 3. A little bit more complicated. Not so complicated, but the form is different. On the first look, it seems complicated, but it is not. Okay. Problem number 3, what will be the integral of the quantity 1 plus x squared over 2 times dx? Okay, the obvious solution of this is to expand first, okay? 1 times dx is just the integral of dx. 1 times dx is dx, take the integral, okay? Plus, x squared over 2 times dx, put that under the integral sign, so it will become the integral of x squared over 2 dx. And here, we got u here, it is x, and du is equal to dx, it is exact, right? Nothing is to be added here for it to be exact. For the second term, actually these two here is not a problem, you just bring it out from the integral, okay? So the value of u for the second one is just simply x. And du is equal to dx. Okay? This dx here is same as this is. You do not have to add anything for it to be exact. That's why I place it here exact. Okay? So proceeding with the integration now, the integral of the differential of dx is just simply x. Okay? We bring up this two here. So this is 1 half. This falls under the power formula, x raised to 2 plus 1, all over 2 plus 1, or simply x cubed over 3. plus C. Simplifying, it will now become x, 1 half times 1 third is 1 sixth. This is x cubed plus C. The final answer is x plus 1 sixth, x cubed plus C. That's the final answer. If you want to verify the correctness of this one, try to differentiate using your knowledge of differential calculus, and what will come out should be this. As simple as that one. So it's a reverse process, plus your knowledge of algebra and the so-called simplification. Okay, let's proceed with number 4. Number 4, it seems complicated on the first look. Okay, I will try to bring out problem number 4. The integral of the quantity, the square root pi.